the Chevy Sprint. About the lowest priced car on the range.
That's where I stopped last night. Okay, good morning. I went to bed about 3:30. There wasn't much of a fire. Shit, I think I got a gambler stopped up here. Let me see what this is about. You good? Apparently the fog light switch stopped working. Apparently all the wiring that I didn't do isn't working, which is a new one for me. But I got the fan working. It's piggybacked off the fog light circuit, so I can't run them individually. But since I don't have very much fuel, and one of our waypoints goes dangerously close back to the town that has a gas station, I'm just going to backtrack a little bit, and the way I figure it, I can get an extra 30 miles range. And while I'm there, I can get an accessory wiring kit and maybe a thermostat, because somebody suggested that I just cut out the thermostat guts and put the frame back in there as a restrictor. And that seems to be splendid. Like, it's a little chilly right now, with the needle is just above cold, which means it's on the dial. That's good. Better too cold than too hot, and my fan is completely switched, and I haven't had to do that yet, but it seems to be holding no problem doing 60. I'll keep you posted. I've got the coordinates list now. Shit. So once I stop, I'll be able to prioritize those. I think we should be able to complete this. or maybe not.
Made it back into town, got some extra gas, and made it back up the mountain, but I started overheating. Looks like since I piggybacked the fan off the light bar circuit, it melted the switch, which is really neat that fusible link didn't fucking work. But I did buy a bunch of extra electrical shit at the store because I thought shit was going to get sketchy. Turns out it did. So I was going to try to get to the top of this mountain and find some shade, but looks like I'm just going to be sitting on the sunny side of this doing a rewire. Keep you posted. Thank you.
Yep, I'm gonna need a strap.
Yeah. Well, what if you divided that by two?
Zero.
Yeah, divide that by two.
Yeah.
No,
that's good.
Nice.
I was real impressed. She had it on less than three.
Good. Nice.
Last time it was on less than three wheels.
Well, I made it into camp. I ran into a group of gamblers. And they striated into different places and got sorted by speed, and I found a good group. Did get stuck in a creek. I knew coming up on it was going to be too deep, but I knew I had support, so I went for it and almost made it. Just didn't have quite enough traction to keep moving. But then the engine got all fucking wet and didn't want to go up a hill, but I ran the piss out of it and seems to be doing all right now. But I think I'm going to go enjoy the fire and probably get to bed early. Here we are, morning of day four. Holy shit, it's only been 3 days. We're an hour away from the next rally point. It looks like the hard route has been closed due to rain because it's just all clay mud, but it's going to be a bitch getting out that far. It says it's...
looks like that was the Flippy Tippy Don't Get Lost NorCal Gambler. It was a good time. I'm glad the roads weren't too horrendously difficult. The Sprint did pretty well, but I really need to watch its weight. I need to maybe take a look at the bump stop, see if I can keep it from... Maybe I could have it bottom out on the fucking body instead of on the tires. Maybe that would prolong some life. Shit. Never mind. There's a fucking bolt in the road. Look at the size of this thing. Good lord. Oh, okay. So we just got out of camp, up to another summit and campground, and back down to where this dude flipped his Xterra a little while ago. So he was telling us not to go up there, so somebody jumps up and says he's going to do it in his brand new F-150 King Lariat. Is that what it is? So it says, who goes with me? So I said shotgun, and I jumped in there. He had heated seats, and so the first river crossing had a massage. Full, like, you could set the vibration and the shiatsu thing separately. So we didn't know where he told us to not go any farther past. So we ended up going up, I don't know how far up of it. Then we had a little award ceremony, and now we're headed back into civilization. Maybe. I've got just enough gas, I think, to make it to an expensive gas station. Hopefully I do. The extra gas can I bought, I decided to flip that because I don't need to be carrying two gas cans. So I'm back to my original 20-liter reserve, and then that's under my bed. So I really try to avoid running out of fuel as a matter of convenience. Then again, I've got 4 days to get to Reno. Well, three, I guess, because I got to work on that. So I'm meeting some dude in Reno, and he wants some parts off the Sprint, and he wants, I guess, help pulling more parts off another Sprint in a junkyard. So I told him I'd do that. I also told him I'd give him a sway bar, but I didn't feel like carrying the weight, and it's not in that good of shape, so I just didn't bring it, and I'm going to tell him I forgot, and I feel bad about it, but that's how it is. Anyway, I'll keep you posted.